There once was a god named Niu Long, whose name means cowherd, who was responsible for the celestial herds in heaven, and he knew of a goddess named Qinu, whose name means weaver girl, who was the seventh daughter of the heavenly queen mother and the jade emperor. She was good at weaving and was responsible for weaving beautiful and colorful clouds. Niu Long was attracted to Qinu, and the two fell in love, but this offended the celestial law of heaven that forbade their romance, and this made the jade emperor and the heavenly queen mother very angry. For having offended their laws, Niu Long was exiled down to earth by the heavenly queen mother and was reincarnated as a baby on earth. Qinu was punished by her father and forced to weave colorful clouds all day long. She suffered from losing her beloved man, and she missed him and wept for him every day. Years later, the now human cowherd Niu Long had not had an easy life. He lost his parents at a young age and had to live with his older brother and his sister-in-law. His brother didn't care about him and treated him harshly. So one day, Niu Long left his brother and decided to live with an aged cow as his only companion. One day up in heaven, the six daughters of the heavenly queen mother asked permission to go down to earth to take a bath in the river with their sister Qinu. Their mother allowed this, and when they were bathing, Niu Long just happened to be passing by the river and saw Qinu amongst her sisters. He was extremely happy to have found her again, apparently still retaining his memories from heaven. He then stole Qinu's clothes and said, "If you agree to marry me, I'll give them back to you, I promise." Qinu suddenly figured out that he was the god she fell in love with years ago, and happily agreed to marry him. Because the fact that she knew him made the fact that he stole her clothes, which made her unable to return home unless she agreed to marry him, less creepy apparently, which I don't see how. They got married and lived a happy life on earth for many years. He worked in the fields while she stayed home weaving and taking care of their two children. After hearing about their marriage, the Jade Emperor was furious and ordered the Queen Mother to bring Qinu back to heaven. She then sent some heavenly troops to get her. The following day, the heavenly troops managed to catch Qinu and flew her back to heaven. Niu Long was devastated that they had taken his wife. And when the old ox heard the sad news, he built a boat for Niu Long to carry him and his children up to heaven. He was able to build it, since as it turned out, the old ox was once a god in heaven who spoke well of Qinu and Niu Long's relationship, which greatly annoyed the queen mother, who then decided to change him into an old ox and exiled him down to earth for daring to express such an opinion. Niu Long got on the boat with his children and were just about to reach Qinu when the heavenly queen mother saw this and removed her golden hairpin to create a river, now known as the Milky Way, between them, keeping them apart. Unable to find a way across the Milky Way, Niu Long could only cry with his children for Qinu on the opposite side. Their deep love for each other moved a flock of magpies, who then flew up and formed a colorful bridge across the Milky Way, allowing Niu Long and Qinu to reunite. The Jade Emperor was also moved by the display, and the family was able to reunite via the magpie bridge once a year on the 7th day of the 7th month on the lunar calendar. Qinu symbolizes the star Vega, and is a part of the constellation Lyra. The magpie bridge symbolizes the star Deneb, and is a part of the constellation Cygnus. And Niu Long symbolizes the star Altair, and he and his children are a part of the constellation Aquila. There was once a young cowherd by the name of Niu Long, and one day he saved an ox when it was sick. And unbeknownst to him, this sick ox used to be the god of cattle, but was downgraded to earth as he had violated the law of heaven. In order to show his gratitude, the old ox helped Niu Long get acquainted with a fairy named Qinu, when she escaped from her boring life in heaven to look for fun on earth, since it is said that the fairy would have to stay here if she failed to return to heaven before morning. Qinu soon fell in love with Niu Long, and they got married without the knowledge of her mother, who was the goddess of heaven. Niu Long and Qinu lived a happy life together. Niu Long worked in the field, while Qinu did weaving at home. After a few years passed, they had two children, one boy and one girl. However, one day, the goddess of heaven found out that Qinu, her daughter, had married a mere mortal. The goddess was furious, and sent her celestial soldiers to bring Qinu back to heaven. That same day, Niu Long returned from working in the fields, and told Qinu, "The old ox has died, and he asked me to peel off his cowhide and said it could help me fly up to the sky when I put it on, if I ever need to." The couple wept for the old ox, and buried him after obtaining his skin. Eventually, the celestial soldiers captured Qinu, and Niu Long was very upset when he found out and put on the cowhide, got his two kids, and he started to fly after her. And just before he caught up with Qinu, the goddess of heaven took out a hairpin and created a huge river between them, and they were separated forever by that river. Heartbroken, Niu Long and his children could only weep bitterly. However, their love moved all the magpies to take pity on them, and they flew up into heaven to form a magpie bridge over the river, so Niu Long and Qinu could meet again. The goddess of heaven was also moved by their love, so she allowed them a meeting on the magpie bridge on that day every year, which happened to be Qinu's birthday, the 7th day of the 7th lunar month. Qinu lived with her sisters and parents up in the heavens. She was responsible for weaving and knitting the clouds of heaven. One day, Qinu and her sisters asked their mother, the heavenly mother, if they could go down to earth to bathe in the river, and their mother agreed. While Qinu and her sisters were taking a bath, a cowherder named Niu Long had fallen in love with Qinu when he was passing by the river. And unlike the Greek goddess Artemis, who was offended that a mere mortal had seen her naked, Qinu decided to stay on earth, and the two started to become closer and closer as years passed. Sometime later, they had two children, a son and a daughter. When the Heavenly Queen Mother found out that Chinu had become engaged with Niulong, she became enraged with fury and sent Chinu back to the heavens where she was punished to weave colorful clouds every day, all while she wept for her beloved husband. Niulong was also overcome with grief and sorrow, and he wept every day as he worked on the farm and cared for his two children. However, one day, Niulong had managed to meet with Chinu again secretly. When Niulong's cow had died, the cow had told Niulong that his hide would hop and fly to the heavens to meet with Chinu again. On their way back to Earth, Chinu and Niulong's happy reunion was short-lived when the guards of heaven had caught Chinu escaping. When Chinu's mother heard of this, she removed her hairpin and created the Milky Way as a river to separate Chinu and Niulong forever. Chinu, who was once again separated from her husband, wept and wept, hoping Niulong would come back someday. Chinu's and Niulong's bond was so strong that it attracted a flock of magpies. The magpies carried Niulong, who carried his two children in baskets, up to the heavens, where they could be with Chinu again. The Heavenly Mother tried everything she could to dispose of Niulong, but it was to no avail, for she failed each time. Unfortunately, their reunion lasted short, as the magpies began to feel tired from carrying Niulong and his two children. And so they were returned to Earth. And on that day every year, a flock of magpies would carry Niulong and his children up to the heavens to be with Chinu again. It is said that it is hard to find a magpie on Chinese Valentine's Day in China because all the magpies fly to the heavens to create the bridge for the couple. Every year on the seventh day of the seventh lunar month, people look up at the night sky searching for the cowherder star and the weaver girl star and hope to see their annual reunion. Unfortunately, when it came to finding different versions of this tale, I couldn't really find any. Most of the tales are the same with just minor differences, and some just started halfway into the story and left information out, which is why I think the first version is the more accurate one since it has almost all the aspects of the second and third one and tells the story completely. This tale inspired the Qixi Festival in China, and it has also been called the Double Seventh Festival, the Chinese Valentine's Day, the Night of the Sevens, or the Magpie Festival. This tale traces its roots back to astrology, specifically the stars Altair and Vega, situated 16 light years apart at opposite ends of the Milky Way. It's been celebrated in a Qixi festival since the Han Dynasty. The earliest known reference dates back to over 2,600 years ago, which is told in a poem from the classic of poetry. The Qixi festival inspired the Tanabata festival in Japan, Jinxiog festival in Korea, and Hat Thik festival in Vietnam. And all of these festivals fell on August 14th this year. They also compare to the Buddhist tale of Manohara and Prince Sudhana, and the Sumerian tale of Inanna and Dumuzi. Since Chinese folklorist and scholar T. Nai Tungu classified them under the Quest for the Lost Wife Index. I will explain each festival and their version of this tale in more detail once I finish working on the respective videos. During the Qixi festival, the celestial bodies appear to convene in the sky, with the star Deneb being seen as a magpie bridge reuniting them. It is seen as an age-old love story written in the stars. In the hearts of generations of Chinese people, the romance has come to represent the power of true love in overcoming great odds if they are not able to always be with us due to long distance. It is said that if it rains on this day, that it was caused by a river sweeping away the magpie bridge, or that the rain is the tears of the separated couple. In ancient times, women would make wishes to the stars of Vega and Altair in the sky during the festival, hoping to have a wise mind, dexterous hand in embroidery and other household tasks, and a good marriage. Traditionally, it was a day when women dressed up in hanfu, a traditional Chinese clothing that has a long flowing robe with loose sleeves and a belt at the waist, and they would spend the day preparing offerings of tea, wine, flowers, and various fruits to pray to Chinu for wisdom and to grant their wishes. Single women would pray to the celestial couple to grant them a good spouse, and newly married women would wish to bear a baby. Later in the night, the women would gather around and commune with each other on threading a needle, and the children would collect flowers and hang them on the horns of oxen to honor the ox who gave his life to help the couple be able to see each other again. According to one source, in recent years, only a few of these customs remain, such as the making of the fried thin pastry known as chao guo, by using three main ingredients, oil, flour, and sugar. The fragrant and sweet pastry dough is then molded into different shapes and decorated with elegant patterns and decorative figures. But as the festival has become increasingly commercialized over the years, it is now converted into how the West celebrates Valentine's Day, with many couples celebrating by giving each other gifts and flowers, and going on dates in China and Taiwan, having lost what made their Valentine's Day so culturally diverse. Bridge of Birds, a novel of an ancient China that never was, is a fantasy novel by Barry Hewitt, first published in 1984. It is the first of three novels in the Chronicles of Master Li and Number 10 Ox series. The second novel is called The Story of the Stone, a Master Li novel, and the third novel is called Eight Skilled Gentlemen. This book is set in a fantastical version of Imperial China. It draws on and reinvents the traditional tale of the cowherd and the weaver girl, and other myths, poems, and incidents from Chinese history. In this book, the cowherd is called Star Shepherd, and he is the nephew of the Emperor of Heaven, known as the August Personage of Jade. He forbade Star Shepherd to ever visit Earth again after learning that he had fallen in love with a young female peasant named Jade Pearl, Weaver Girl's name, and ignored his task in heaven. Though he did show compassion once he talked with Jade Pearl and he gave her 3 feathers from the King of Birds, and made her the Princess of Birds, and decreed that on the 7th day of the 7th moon, she would be allowed to call on all the birds to create a bridge to see Star Shepherd again. And so long as she returned to Earth on the 1st day of the 1st moon and didn't forget to visit on the appointed date, she could continue to visit him once every year. But then something happened to Jade Pearl that makes her break her promise of going to see Star Shepherd on the 7th day of the 7th moon. At the end of the book, Master Li says how many priests and eunuchs will believe this book is too crude and will instead focus on a more lighthearted version of events, and will make a lover's festival that celebrates a meek little goddess who weaves seamless robes and a meek little god who milks cows, with a few magpies tossed in for comic effect, as well as make changes to the other tales referenced in this book. This book is available on Amazon, and as a mass market paperback, costs $7.99. This tale is referenced in the 2010 film The Karate Kid, who, contrary to its name, has nothing to do with karate. It is about a young boy named Dre and his widowed mother who have just moved to Beijing, China due to a job transfer, and though he isn't happy about the move, he tries to make the best of it. Once in his new home, he goes to the nearby park and meets a girl named Mei Ying. And to me, they seem to parallel the couple in the tale, since they both came from different backgrounds. She was a dedicated violinist and was held to a high standard, while Dre was just a new kid and had no particular set of skills that set him apart from others until he started to learn Kung Fu for self-defense. They immediately struck up a friendship and he brought some much-needed fun into her life. They even attended the Qishu Festival, and you can see a lot of magpie decorations and even a float depicting the two lovers reuniting. Dre and Mei Ying meet up and go backstage where the tale is being told, and Mei Ying translates for Dre. A goddess and a man met and fell in love, but the goddess's mother did not approve of this match. So, she cast a large river in the sky to separate them forever. But once a year, all the birds form a bridge for them, since they are sad that they have to be apart. And because of this, the couple is able to see each other for one night a year. After Mei Ying finishes translating the tale to Dre, they promise to be there for each other's important events, hers being her violin recital, and his being his kung fu tournament. They then share a kiss just as the goddess and man do as the tale ends. Back at school, Dre convinces Mei Ying to leave school early with him to have some fun before her big recital the next day. And she manages to have fun and relax, until her father calls to inform her that her recital has been changed to that same day. And her parents are visibly annoyed that she wasn't at school, causing her to almost be late for a recital. And just like the Weaver Girl's mother and father in the tale forbade her to be with the cowherd due to her no longer doing her job in heaven and disobeying their laws, Mei Ying's father tells her to let Dre know that they can no longer be friends, since he's a bad influence on her. But unlike the cowherd, Dre later apologizes in Mandarin to Mei Ying's father to forgive him for bringing dishonor onto their family, and to please give him a second chance at being his daughter's friend, to which Mei Ying's father agrees, and Mei Ying is able to cheer Dre on at his kung fu tournament. Something that I think if the cowherd had at least tried to do with the Weaver Girl's parents, then maybe the Milky Way wouldn't be keeping them apart. But then again, we wouldn't have this interesting tale.